Thomas Jefferson died.
John Adams died. Oh,
we are gathered here today, July 7th, 1826, to celebrate the life of John Adams. His sons, John Quincy Adams and Thomas Adams, are here to say the union.
To celebrate my father's life. I am John Quincy Adams, his son and President of the United States. He was born October 30th, 1795 in Massachusetts. His parents, John and Susanna, loved him and cared for him very much. Susanna was known to have a very fiery temper.
What shall we name him?
We shall name him John Adams Jr., just like you.
Hello, John. Welcome to Quincy. I am the deacon here. I am sometimes the tax collector. You will love it here.
My father was young. He was very smart. He loved school and learning. He was outgoing. He always tried his best. And it paid off when he graduated from Harvard University.
Congratulations. Thank you.
John Adams. Congratulations.
Thank you. I am so blessed to have the chance to study here.
It was our pleasure, John.
When my father graduated, he met the love of his life, my mother, Abigail Adams. He met in the summer of 1759. In 1762, they were completely in love. They were always sending each other love letters. They married on October 25th, 1764.
Like a fat kid loves cake. Are you religious? Because you're answering my prayers.
To your heart, meet me tomorrow.
Hello, Abigail. You look beautiful. Why don't we sit down?
Thanks, John. You look awful handsome yourself. I just want to tell you that
I actually want to tell you something. I love you, Abigail. You're the peanut to my butter, the jelly to my bean. Abigail, will you marry me?
Yes, yes, yes! I love you so much!
Deacon John, take Abigail to be your wife, to love and care for her through sickness and health.
I do.
And Abigail, do you take John to be your husband, to love and care for him through sickness and health?
I do.
And now, by the powers invested in me, you are now husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
I'm now going to let my brother Thomas speak. Thank you for listening to me.
Hello to all. Thank you. I remember when I was young, all my little brothers and I would hang out together. Some of them passed before my father, so I speak on my behalf and theirs.
I love you all so much. I know you're too young to realize, but your mother and I are so blessed to have you.
I love you, Dada!
We had such fun times when we were little. I know my mom and dad were sad to see us grow up so fast, but the times flew by. I remember one of the times I was most proud of my father was when he was elected for vice president.
As president of the colonies, I would like to present my vice president, John Adams.
I am honored to be the first vice president of our nation. I believe that great things will be accomplished as Mr. President and I run the country. Thank you all who voted for me. I am honored. I know that with each colony having their own government, the land we live on will become a better place for all of us. Thank you again. I am glad to serve all of you.
This is where we're going to be living, the great colony in Philadelphia. You and the boys will love it here.
I know we will. I'm so proud of you, honey. I was excited when my dad was vice president, but I became even more proud when he became the ruler of our land. the president.
Thank you all. The 65 electoral votes are the reason I stand president here before you. I only won by 3 electoral votes, but they made all the difference. I am happy to say I am the first president to live in the White House in Washington, D.C. Without further ado, I present my vice president. I know we are opposing parties. We will still work together to make each and every one of you a happy citizen of our nation. I can't stand you. You beat me by 3 votes, and you're acting like you beat me by 1,000 votes. I have a say, too.
I'm the president. I am higher up than you. That means I have more power than you. I am your boss.
My dad always tried to work together with everyone, same party or not. He sometimes fought, but in the end, everything turned out okay. I mean, look at me. Although my father is a Unitarian and a Federalist, you people here today don't care about that. You're here to celebrate his life. Thank you all for coming. Brother and I stand in front of my father's grave, I think, how could this happen? He was a strong man who I grew up looking up to. He is the reason I am president right now. I don't know what I would have done without him. I love my dad and I will miss him terribly. There was only 2 points in my life when I cried, when my mother died and my father died. Goodbye, Dad. I love you.
Can I go?
Oh my god.
Oh, Bridget!